So I've got an interesting project that I'm working on, and I haven't really shown much about it, but I'm building a wind tunnel. My buddy Wolf Dilworth came up with the idea and said that we needed to build something so that we could teach students how an airfoil or a wing works. And so I'm building this, and I'm making it automated. I've got a very, very powerful turbine in the back here, and I've got a closed off section here with some honeycomb in it, which prevents a swirling wind from developing because of the turbine. And then at the other side, it's kind of hard to see, but there's another honeycomb at that side. So we get a very nice laminar airflow through the system. But we've got our test chamber here. Easy access, we'll be able to put things in, and it's going to have some intelligence. I've got a Raspberry Pi, and I've got a circuit board assembly that I'm working on to test the different components. I've got things like these two load sensors right here. These measure force when things are pushed down on them. One of them is going to measure lift. The other one is going to measure drag. I've got a new toy here, which is a wind speed indicator. It will allow me to calibrate the machine. And you see I put it on a stand so that I can bring it up and put it in here and then calibrate the system, because it's got a PDOT tube up inside there. You see that? And that little tube will measure the wind flow once I get it all calibrated out.
So this is the fan that I've decided to use for the windmill project. It's got a digital controller, but it also has the capability to plug into here a cable that I can hook up to an Arduino or to a Raspberry Pi and control it. And it's a pretty incredible little unit. It's fairly quiet. And this is number 2 of 8. And there's an incredible amount of wind coming out the back of here.
So I built a new holder, and this is the new anemometer, and it slips into there just like that, see? And it's not going to go anywhere. It's got a good grip on it, so I can take it and put it up inside the wind tunnel, and we can do our tests. So let's see how this thing performs. So let's give this thing a test and see what it does. And I'll run this thing through the different speeds here. We'll start off at 1 and then I'll ramp it up to number 8 on the control here. One of the other things I like about this, besides having 2 digits of accuracy, is it's got the thermometer up here, and this one also has humidity, which the other one didn't have. And I've already cycled this thing through the minimum and maximum, and I've cycled it through the different ranges. I have had no problems at all with this one. I am very, very happy with it as compared to the other one. So I'm going to definitely give this one a 5-star review, and I'm finally happy to have a good working anemometer for the wind tunnel. Now, I'm using a program that's called Gambus. Gambus is a version of Basic, and I have some people that I go to the Raspberry Pi meetups and stuff, and they will give me a little bit of grief because they're programming in C or Python, and they say that, you know, Basic is not a sophisticated language. And to that, usually what I say is, well, let me see what you've done with your projects. And they show me some text scrolling up a screen, and I say, yeah, that's nice, okay. And then I show them, this is mine. So we're going to have gauges that'll display the angle of attack, and that'll display the wind speed, and the fan RPM. There's going to be temperature gauges in there that'll read the temperature. And as I change the speeds on the fan, I've got little indicators that'll indicate that. So they can laugh at my little Gambus all they want, but I think it's an incredible program. And I've got another series on the Raspberry Pi, and I'm delving deeper and deeper into Gambus as I figure it out, and I'm going to run the video series for the wind tunnel and Gambus simultaneously, so that as I progress on both of them, you'll be able to see how it all works. But it's really great. You can lay out your forms and everything, and what you see is what you get. So really handy, really powerful, and that's all I got for this video, but we'll have more soon.